Shalom. First off, I want to excuse me, all praises, glory, and honor unto Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Baha, Rukakadash. Double honors unto the apostles and elders, a great millstone. Shalom, peace, and blessings to the Hakim who go out in the four corners of the earth to teach this truth to the nation of Israel and wake up the elect. Peace and shalom to you, Hakim. Peace and blessings to you, Hakim, as well. You know, it's at camp, you know, today, and we're going into how the so-called Native Americans are the nation of Israel, and you know, some of the Northern Kingdom as well. But you know, we got into a lot about the tribe of Gad, which is who you call so-called Native Americans. And, you know, we kind of got into some artifacts, you know, there was shekels that were found that we had Hebrew writing on them, you know, that predate the coming of the so-called white man, predate Columbus. You know, you have the stones that were found in Ohio with the ancient Paleo-Hebrew written on them. And, you know, there's plenty of physical evidence. New Mexico, you have the stone with the Ten Commandments on it, written in ancient Paleo Hebrew that you know, predates Yahweh Shai. So all of this evidence pointing to the fact that the Northern Kingdom is the Latino, the Seminole Indian, and the American Indian, so-called Native Americans, however you want to say it, right? And it's crazy because this week I was doing a study on massacres and getting into some of the Native American massacres, so-called Native American massacres. And you know, you had the a lot of different tribes, you know, went through hell, you know, at the hands of the so-called white man, right? The devil, according to the scriptures. I'm gonna try to find some of these, the name of some of these. You know, the ones that I always bring up are the obvious ones. The Wheel Massacre of Northern California. The Wounded Knee Massacre. Right, but there were so many. The Bear River Massacre. Maria's River Massacre. All the men were out hunting. Again, another massacre full of women, children, and elderly. Which almost all of these were of women, children, and elderly. You know, that's, we know our seed survived because Esau's a damn pussy. Salakia for my language, but he always waited until he didn't have to fight any warriors, any Gadite warriors. The Apalachee Massacre. The Old Shasta Town Massacre, which is the tribe that my mother belonged to, the Shasta Nation. I think they call themselves the Shasta Yurok Nation. That's the tribe I'm enrolled in. Klamath River Massacre, the Bridge Gulch. The 1853 War of Extermination was a war that these Edomites declared on the nation of Gad. Right? And in California, they wanted to wipe out the whole population of Native Americans. That was their goal. And they weren't going to spare any or keep any prisoners. So, you know, this was the, again, leading up to what this happening. You know, this was the judgment that the Most High Power put on the nation of Israel. And that's how we know that these Northern Kingdom just so happened to be the Native Americans, Latinos, and Seminole Indians. Through the curses and through the prophecies, right? A Gad, a troop shall overcome thee, but you shall overcome at the end. And it's not the end yet. but they shall still overcome, right? And this devil, you know, during these massacres, you know, during the Sand Creek Massacre, you know, the next day he wore body parts of the Nation of Gad and paraded through the town of Denver, the city of Denver, wearing these body parts. So that also proves that he's the wicked, the devil, Satan's counterpart, physical counterpart, right? The devil. So for all you Jakes out there, you call yourself Israelites and don't believe that these are your people, you're sadly mistaken. And the Most High is going to show you in the kingdom. While you shamefaced, there's going to be 12,000 from each tribe, and some of those are going to be Northern Kingdom, and you're going to have to bow down your head in shame to them and show respect, you know? And ultimately, you know, that won't be forever. It says forever, but it means for a long period of time. But you're going to learn. Well, you're going to learn today that, Yahweh Shem Yahshua are the ultimate power. And just because you have a vain opinion that these aren't your people, it doesn't matter what you think. The Most High, this is the Most High show. And you're just a part of it. So keep thinking that. You know, they're supposed to be non-believers. They're supposed to be the blind leading the blind into the ditch. I just wanted to bring that out because there's a lot of controversy within Israel that you got to be fucking Wesley Snipes ass looking, you know, so like it for my French, but you know, you got to look like Wesley Snipes or Shaft to be an Israelite. It's just a bunch of dumb niggas that ain't got no faith, who don't understand the truth, you know, going out on the highways and byways and teaching madness. But that was prophesied to happen, you know. There has to be the house of David and the house of Saul, right? And the house of David is going to stay faithful. You know, we believe in the 12 tribe sign. You know, we believe the earth is round. It's a sphere, right? We believe that Yahusha is coming in the chariots, which are called UFOs. We believe he's a so-called black man from the tribe of Judah, right? We believe that, that America is Babylon, Sodom, and Egypt, spiritually, according to the scriptures. You know, that's our faith. You know, that's what we stand upon. So, you know, I don't want to make this too long. This is just a dashboard pistol. I'm on my way home from camp. You know, it just vexes my spirit. These damn niggas don't understand the truth. You know, they don't want to adhere to what's really going on. So, you know, with that, I'm going to wrap it up. Give all praise and glory and honor to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, Bahashem Rukak Kadash. Double honors unto the apostles and elders, great millstone, and shalom to the Akim, the faithful brothers that go out on these highways and byways week in and week out to prophesy the downfall of America. Baba Ba, shalom.